The seed was definitely laid in 1993. Dr. John W. Gardner came to Houston to speak to the Houston Forum. He said, a city is never finished. You can't build it and leave it standing like the pharaohs did the pyramids. It has to be built and rebuilt and recreated in each generation by believing, caring men and women. And then he finished, it is now our turn. How can you hear those words, it is now our turn, and not do something about it? The seed was planted then, and it had the opportunity to sprout in 1999, when one day out of the blue, I received a phone call from Ned Holmes, who was the incoming chairman of the Greater Houston Partnership. And I remember his exact words. He says, Gene, we have a wonderful title over here at the partnership that's not being used, Center for Houston's Future. Will you be the chairman and take it to where it needs to be for Houston?
Our vision is to advance the Houston region as one of the top 10 global communities in which to work and live. And one of the things that we at the center feel very strongly about is that we must look at the region as a whole.
This is the only organization in this region that is dedicated to looking over the horizon and finding out what opportunities and challenges are coming. It's an organization that rather than do the work ourselves, we have collaboration with a lot of other existing organizations.
From the very beginning, some of the principles of Center for Houston's Future is first, concentrate our energies on the points of maximum leverage. Another is, it's been regional from the very beginning. And another is that everything is collaborative. And I guess I could say also a pretty powerful idea that it is true, and they say that there's no amount to how much good you can get done if you don't care who gets the credit.
In a time like today, with the economy the way it is, we've got to be more creative and more inventive than ever. And we have to look at how we can all work together and create the best possible region in which to work and live.
But because of the planning that we're doing in the Center for Houston's Future, because of the work that we're doing to develop leaders that will care about the community and about our civic projects, we're very, very comfortable that it's going to be a very successful, a very promising future for us.
I'm sure there are people that would like to get involved in the many exciting things that we do here at the Center for Houston's Future. One of those things is to be a part of the Friends of the Future. For a small amount of money, you can receive our newsletter, you can be invited to future events. We'd like you to be a part of Houston Have Your Say, a partnership with Channel 8, PBS. It's a live, one-hour town hall meeting. The next one we have coming up is on the economy. If you're interested in being interviewed or being part of a focus group for our scenario planning project, we'd love to get you involved. If you're a corporation and you'd like to get some of your employees involved, you can certainly nominate your employees to be a part of the leadership forum. The future is not a fate, it's a choice. We have the ability to make choices today that can create a positive future for our region tomorrow. So let's do it. That's why it's so important for people to support the work of the Center for Houston's Future.
It is indeed our turn. And maybe it's an obligation that we feel, but we also feel that it is the most immense privilege to be able to take our turn.